Hello, I'm Nigel Larkin. I'm a paleontological conservator and preparator. This is Dean Lomax.
Hello, I'm a palaeontologist and honorary scientist at the University of Manchester and research associate at Doncaster Museum and Art Gallery.
Dean's here in particular because one of his real passions and areas of expertise is ichthyosaurs. And because I'm a paleontological conservator and preparator, I'm used to cleaning specimens, taking them apart, remounting them, that kind of thing. And between us, we're going to work on this skull and some of the associated skeletal pieces from the Thinktank Museum in Birmingham. This was found in the 1950s, 1955, I think, in Warwickshire. And obviously it was found in pieces and they've glued it all back together. They've used an excessive amount of glue, I have to say, compared to what we do these days. So we need to remove a lot of that glue to see what's underneath, to find out what's bone, what's wood. Because in areas they've used substantial pieces of wood, like this part of the jaw here at the back, to actually hang the bones on, if you like, to give it some substance and solidity, because the bones are made up, a lot of them, out of quite small fragments. But also back in the 1950s, it was difficult for them to get comparative material to look at, really. They didn't have the internet to get photographs to put these things back together accurately. But Dean's been around the country looking at ichthyosaur skulls around the world, in fact, and is able to say which bits of this are wood, which bits of it are real, and really how we have to reconfigure it to make it much more anatomically correct.
That's exactly, so as you point out, this portion here is sort of the one that's most evident straight away, that the portion of the lower jaw is made of wood here, but you've got sections all at the back which are portions of wood and actually constructed to make it look as if it's real, and you've got portions as well at the front here and at the side of this portion of the skull. So actually there's quite a lot of sort of carved portions in here of wood, and I think even polystyrene, right, or something like that.
The areas where you can see there's white bits here, and yeah, there are some areas on the front. That's because I've already started cleaning this up before Dean arrived to look at this, because I need to remove some of that glue, some of the paint that was on the wood, so that we can differentiate between the wood, etc., and the bone. And now that I've done that, I think the next stage is probably to measure this specimen, describe it as accurately as possible as it currently is. And then that will enable us to get our heads around it and decide what needs to be removed, what needs to be repositioned.
Yeah, I think that's the best way forward. Then we can decide then literally what to take off, examine those bones individually, do the measurements, high resolution photographs, and sort of then hopefully rebuild it from the top down, sort of thing.
Yeah, and it should be much more anatomically correct, the whole process.
Yeah, definitely. So before we take apart the skull, it's very important that we actually take several different measurements whilst it's actually three-dimensional. So a few of those measurements will be the skull length, which will be from here to the tip of the snout, the jaw length from the back all the way to the end of the jaw, and also a couple of individual skull measurements as well, which include, for example, this one, which will be the premaxillary length. So is this point here, which is the anterior process of the maxilla, all the way to the tip of the jaw. So as an example, we would measure from there to the tip of the jaw. Okay, so I've just taken the premaxillary segment, the measurement for that, the length, and it turns out it's about 38 centimetres, which is actually a lot larger than some of the earlier Jurassic ichthyosaurs, such as the very famous Ichthyosaurus genus. In fact, actually a lot larger than some of those skulls. So we're dealing with quite a beast.